Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. MACMOST is brought to you by the more than 300 people that support it on Patreon. Find out how you can become a part of it at MACMOST.com/Patreon. So today I'm going to show you how to print out a file listing of the contents of a folder. So, say you have a folder like this and it has a variety of different files and folders in it. Fortunately, there's no print command in the Finder. So I can select this folder here. You think under File, Print, it might be a way to actually print or export a list. But there isn't. However, you can still do it several ways. So the first way I'm going to show you is I'm going to select all the items I want. So I use Shift and click there to select everything. And I'm going to go into TextEdit and I'm going to create a new document. And note that it has to be a plain text document, not a rich text one. And I'm going to simply drag these files to this document. And since it's a text editor, it's going to correctly assume that I want a text version of this, which is basically going to be the path for all the files. So you can see here's a listing of all the files in TextEdit. So I could print that out. It gives me the full path. So if I wanted to make it simpler, I could actually select this, copy, do a find, and paste it in there, and then say replace it with nothing. So I'm going to have nothing here on this next line and to replace all. So now I've got just the file name since I've replaced all the paths. Now another thing that I could do is I could get not just the files in this folder but the subfolders as well. If I go to the list view and I open up some of these subfolders in there, and I could do all of them or I can do just some, whatever I want. So now you'll see if I can click on one and I can grab them all. I'm going to actually use Command A this time to grab all of them. And you can see it grabs the files even in the subfolders. So now when I drag and drop into TextEdit, I get files even down inside some of those special folders there. So I get a longer listing. So that's how you can do it just using TextEdit, just to get the bare minimum, just the file names. Now next I'm going to try this in Terminal. So Terminal, being command line interface to your Mac, is a great way to get file listings. So I can easily get into this folder by simply going CD for change directory, and then I'm going to drag from the Finder the folder there, and it's going to give me the full path to it. So now all I have to do is hit return and I'm in this directory. Now I can actually do LS for listing and just see what files are there. So you can see now I've got the names of these files. I can select and copy and paste them into TextEdit or something else. I could actually even just print the window here if I don't mind the stuff at the top and the bottom. But I could also do more than that, because I could do ls and dash l, and l would give me more stuff. So it's going to give me a little listing here. It's going to include the size, the date, and the file name, and some other stuff like permissions and such. You can get really specific on what ls will show you. So if you want to play around with this, do man for manual ls, and you get a ton of different options for using ls, and then you can have this customized output that you can then copy and paste and print out easily. Alright, so here's a final way to do it, and that's by dragging and dropping the folder to your printer. Now, how do you do that? How do you drag and drop something to the printer? Well, if you go into System Preferences and then you go to Printers and Scanners, you'll see your printers here. Now it would be great if you could drag and drop it there, but you can't. However, you can drag this out and stick it anywhere you want. I showed you a while ago how to stick it on in your dock. You can also stick it on the desktop. And wherever you put it, it's a shortcut to that printer. I can now quit System Preferences, and now I have something that I can drop it to. So instead of dropping all these files here, because if I drop an individual file, it's going to actually print that file. But if I drop a folder onto it, this is what I get. It's going to go and want to print, and it's going to give me a little preview here of this document. And you can see it's going to give me file names. It's going to give me the size and the time. So now I can print it. I can even go and open it, save it as a PDF, or directly open it in preview. So I could see here my stuff, and I could even copy and paste this text if I wanted to, or just send it along, or continue by printing it. Thank you.